We have 10 votes for and we have 16 votes for Councillor Ian McGarvey, and I deem Councillor Ian McGarvey elected. Climbing mountains every day of their life. Maybe doesn't know how to come to terms with them. Maybe has difficulty. But the one thing I do want to say to all of you, the contribution each and every one of you can make to this country is going to be so important. Everybody talks about hardship. hardship has always been around. And Margie's sitting down there, and I can tell you one thing certain sure. I seen her out with a shovel mixing concrete that they could build onto the house. So that's the kind of life she has led. So there are big changes since. Maybe all for the better. But nevertheless, we had come to terms with what we'll say. We always had to live within our means. We always intended to do so. And unfortunately for me now, much of the problems that are being caused owing to the fact that we'll say, there were bank officials prepared to throw money out. You nearly think they never wanted it back. And unfortunately, many people fell for what they were doing. But what all of us must realise, they were getting a bonus for handing out that money. And the amount of bonus they were getting was a disgrace to start with. The top people being paid the amount they were being paid out of some of the banks. And when I hear even yet somebody talking about 843,000 for a top person in one of the banks, you know, it makes the mind boggle. But I want to say another thing. We, the people now, including this council, are paying for that. We may be critical of government, but I never shoot the messenger. Because they're trying to do a job as we're doing here ourselves. Trying to manage what we can do to provide the service of this lesson for the people. I think the day has come in Donegal where we must all realise every one of us has a contribution to make. That contribution will benefit somebody. Never misunderstand that the day has come for all of us and for our young people particularly. And we want to support them from that to the elder day. And think of the phase they go through in life and the difficulties they face getting from one day to the other maybe, getting from that to the year's end, studying and all the rest of the demands that are on them. But nevertheless, when I think of one figure where they were quoting when President Kennedy came here 50 years ago, there were 25 million people in America of Irish descent. Do you know what has happened? Our Irish are all abroad. And more going by the day. To me, that's so sad when you leave your country. And I worked a year in Germany, and I know I left Margie at home with a wife and three children, the wife and three children with six cows, and maybe other animals as well. A car and a fleet, she said she hadn't ever before. So that's the kind of life I had been through. But I knew she would manage, and I knew she had the determination to manage. And thank God we can still have the help, because I've prayed that more than anything else. And I want to say, being elected mayor of this county, I don't want to make any difference as any councillor in here. And I'll always show the ladies' preference first. Because I was taught, even when I was brought up, if you see a lady anywhere, give her your seat. Allow her go before you and do all this. I'm still doing the same thing yet. So, to all the friends that are here today, I want to extend a very warm welcome to all of you. Because that's an opportunity, as I said, to realise and spread the news out there. We're all in this together in Donegal. We have a job to do, and I have no hesitation in saying, I want to sit down with the staff here, who I've admired since I've come in here. And that's all the staff, because again, like many other members, I'm sure you will agree, they have always been very helpful any time around me. They go out of their way to assist us, within the possibilities that's available to them. A tribute was paid to our manager, and I can only but wish him and all the staff well. And in my term as councillor, thank you, sir. In my term as mayor, I want to facilitate every councillor that's on here to do a better job for their area. If I can't do that, I'll be failing in my job. So I look forward to the challenge, and I saw many of them along the way. And certain sure one thing it has been referred to, I've been very fortunate in health. And I wish each and every one of you that has attended here today well, and always remember that it's your county. And remember another thing, when I think of our country, say, 9,000-10,000 years ago, there wasn't one individual in this island. Ice Age was here. We have struggled with people since, and unfortunately we can't fully coexist. It's a sad story. We were stuffed with education at a big expense to people. And I want to always be available and will be in the future. And I only hope, just because there's a chain around my neck, that nobody starts leading me about. All of you. When I needed it, saved to leave me about, there was another bill. So listen, may I thank again the porter, seconder, pay tribute to the outgoing mayors and to the work they have done. And I know, as illustrated earlier, it's not an easy job. But I welcome the challenge. And I see Joe Duffy here, and many a time I passed him the ball, I never gave her back.
Your memory's not bad.
Because it's not only given her away. But listen to me, that's the kind of life I had through sport and everything else. And as I say to yourself, all of you, that I welcome the opportunity. I will appreciate the help of all the members, and I'll have no hesitation in listening to you. And to the staff, manager, staff, everyone, I want to see his work for the benefit of this country at all times. So thank you very much, Albert.